Anti-corruption is another big issue. The politics of the environment is one of China's most discussed topics. This is the SARS crisis, and this is about the effect of AIDS on China.
AIDS has been one of the most difficult subjects in China for journalists to cover. Dong Janhai is dying, but he didn't contract AIDS from unprotected sex, nor is he a needle-sharing drug addict. AIDS in Henan and nearby provinces is a story of poverty, corruption, cover-up. A tragedy of people shunned by the state.
I once went into a village and heard a child's voice in the distance calling, "Come down, come down." It turned out two people had met through blood selling, got married and had a child. The child was born with AIDS and the father died. The mother couldn't go on and hanged herself. The child didn't understand what had happened to his mother and just hugged her feet crying, "Come down."
Dr. Gao has become a heroine in China for her pioneering work promoting AIDS awareness. She categorizes the tragedy as one of China's black holes, neglected by government and media. Shuang Miao Village, Henan Province, in January 2005, the night before yet another funeral. Yang Guixiang strokes the photo of her deceased husband, Zhu Jinzhong, propped up against his coffin. He'd sold his blood to commercial blood collecting clinics to raise extra money to support her and their two children. But for years, HIV-contaminated blood had been passing into the population through unsafe transfusion practices and unsterilized equipment. What makes Yang Guixiang's grief so poignant is that her husband's death, like the deaths of thousands in Henan province, was avoidable. Some officials knew the blood collection procedures were spreading disease, but kept quiet.
Some officials are reluctant to publicize AIDS because they're worried there'll be discrimination against the area, that economic development will be affected. No one will buy their products, no one will come and invest. Some areas still have these reservations. So it's possible that in a minority of places, the full extent of the epidemic has not been reported.
The next day, people flocked to Zhu Jinzhong's funeral. There have been over 150 AIDS funerals in Shuang Miao village, but Zhu Jinzhong was a hero. After he was diagnosed, he cared for over 50 children orphaned by AIDS in the village. Then he was featured in a program by China Central Television, and the donations flooded in. That's when local government became interested. They deemed him unfit because he had AIDS, closed the orphanage, took the children away, and appropriated the money. Official figures say 69,000 have contracted AIDS from blood selling. Activists fear the figures could be much higher. A third of mothers with HIV from blood selling in Henan are passing it on to their babies. And by covering up the problem, officials ensured AIDS would claim still more victims.
I've known people who sold blood before 1996 and were infected. But in 97 and 98, they were still being invited back to hospital to donate their blood for transfusions. The problem was the local doctors didn't know there was AIDS in the area, so the disease was still being spread.
The central government is belatedly providing resources and support. But some local officials have embezzled money, blankets and food intended for victims. They chase away doctors and journalists from AIDS villages. And although unsafe blood collection practices were made illegal in 1996, Dr. Gao is sure the lethal trade continues.
Those officials who encourage blood selling should be locked up, even executed. Look, we've had a blood transfusion law for 10 years. How can they still encourage the illegal blood trade? What are these vampires doing in power? Why are they still alive?
Family and villagers start to dig Zhu Jinzhong's grave. It's frosty and the ground is hard, but they're used to it. The frustration of AIDS victims at inadequate medical care and government indifference has led to violent clashes. A news item filmed off the television shows the Communist Party and police sending a force of 600 against just 15 AIDS activists in Xiongqiao village in Henan. A dozen villagers were injured, including an 8-year-old boy trying to defend his sick mother. AIDS victims are just part of a growing underclass whose demands for social justice are intensifying. There's a deep gulf between rich and poor, with most of the poor in the countryside. China's economic miracle has stranded over 300 million people at the margins.
If this inequality persists in the long term, and if people continue to be marginalized, then of course it's worrying. The thing is, now we recognize this phenomenon, we can't ignore it. We hope we have the sense.